My name is Woland. I like Lily Allen, George Formby, James Blunt, and the Swingle Singers. But most of all, I like trains. And naturism, sometimes both. I starred in my own hit show at the Edinburgh Festival, all about the history of the locomotive industry. I have now committed elements of this show into a 7-part mini-series. My lecture is very detailed and heavy on the subject of trains, and it's not funny. As train enthusiasts, we are sometimes a source of amusement. But we dress like this because it's practical. We're not looking for love. We like trains. I have a girlfriend. You didn't expect me to say that, did you? No one does. The possibility that a person of the opposite sex has found me attractive is a constant surprise to everyone, especially me. This is Laura. Isn't she pretty? It just shows you there is someone for everyone. This is my very favorite picture. It reflects the special joy we have shared for the past 5 years. I'm only sorry we didn't meet 25 years ago, but she would have been only 14. And 14-year-old girls know absolutely nothing about trains. I'm very much an admirer of the television conjurers Darren Brown and Sally Morgan. Their brand of suggestive illusion has inspired me to unlock my ESP and explore powers of a memory. Now, I don't claim to possess their extraordinary abilities, but using my local shared book of shared allocation numbers and a randomly generated code, I will perform a little bit of magic. 65F. Well, that's range math. I have a problem with this, because it's not correct. Fridays is fish night, not a Wednesday.
There is nothing, absolutely nothing wrong with Grangemouth.
I live in Grangemouth. There was nothing wrong with Grangemouth, except that, unfortunately, Grangemouth lost its passenger railway station in 1968, the year I was born.
There's nothing wrong with Grangemouth that a railway station wouldn't fix.
The people of Grangemouth are rightly proud of their association with Davros, who, before his eviction, lived in a flat off Union Road. It would be fair to say, Davros liked a party.
I'm off for a kebab!
Davros was quite a character, and a common sight popping around to R.S. McCall to collect his copy of Guitar Magazine. They must have been out of Guitar Magazine, as he's plumped for a copy of Kerrang. Possibly that fascinating article on Biffy Clyro caught his eye. You would think that being interested in trains and performing magic would have made me very popular at school. You'd be correct. I was very popular with the school bullies. Particularly Rory McIlroy. He was a dreadful bully. He beat me every single day, twice on a Sunday, and he made me pop round to his house for that. For 2 years, including holidays. He was very thorough. He may have been a horrible, evil, despicable bully, but at least he had integrity, which I admired. Of course, back then there was no Childline, no Anti-Bullying Alliance, no Kidscape. However, these days I'm never very far away from this. Geordie Marsh's Shawshank Redemption Guide to Beating the Bullies, Volume 2. Fear can hold you prisoner. Hope can set you free. Since being bullied for not being as pretty as Jordan, Jodie propelled herself into the spotlight with the release of this rich tome. Its bounty is priceless. With this book, I am readily armed with the ammunition to deal with the taunts. It's bursting at the seams with such powerful put-downs as, "Salvation lies within," "Get busy living," or "Get busy dying," and "What is your malfunction, you fat barrel of monkey spunk?" Thanks to Jodie, the children at the school no longer bother me. In fact, this book has been so effective, the council has requested I take an alternative route to the one that passes the school. So like Jodie, I am one of life's survivors. My name is Woland Dootson, and I like trains. next week on Roland's Small Packages. A peaceful picnic turns into a decision-making nightmare, a one-way door. And just where in hell's teeth does Laura think she's going? Tune in next Friday, about tea time.